Stephen preached about the Lord. Folks were saved and folks were healed as they heard his word. Satan did not like it. Soon he had his crowd, and as he would try, they heard Stephen cry out.
Hello, everybody. This is yours truly, the Evangelist Willie Grizzle from the House of Prayer Radio Ministries. Pastor Steve Bailey will be on shortly. So, my friends, grab your Bibles, grab your heart and your soul. But most of all, keep on praying. If there's anything that you'd like to pray about today, leave it in the comment area. We will be honored to pray for any situation you have. This is yours truly, the Evangelist Willie Grizzle.
Through the gates of glory and down the streets of gold marched the hero of the Lord into heaven's fold. When he met the Master at that great white throne, I believe he smiled and said, Stephen, welcome.
Well, glory, hallelujah, everybody. This is yours truly, Evangelist Willie Grizzle, with my pastor, Pastor Steve Bailey. Praise God. You know, we're in the house today. You know, it's a Wednesday. It's a beautiful day. Another day to be alive, ain't it, Pastor?
Amen.
Praise God. You know, God has made another day. It ain't going to be another day in the future like this day today. See, my friend, today you got a choice. You can be serving God or you can please God, or you can be of yourself, pleasing yourself. Praise God. You know, me and the brother here, we were talking about this. Praise God. We were talking about, what is your contractor today? Who is the one thing that fixes things in your life? Like, I mean, who do you call upon when nobody else can help? But this man here can. And I'm talking about Jesus Christ. Praise God. The contractor that can heal a broken heart and never leave a scar.
Amen.
I'm talking about the man that hears your cries when you're in the dark. I'm talking about the man that healed the lying, sick, and the blind. Praise
Amen.
God. Today we're talking about the great I Am, the Amen. Great mighty God of heaven. He wears many hats, don't he, Pastor?
Amen.
Praise God. And when you're down, he'll pick you up.
Amen.
When you're trapped, he always makes a way out. See, my friend, you got to understand, there ain't nothing that God can't do. Praise God. So, brothers and sisters, as I've been lagging on testimonies lately, so I apologize for that. If you would like to call in, please call in 270-681-8098. We've had a couple call in, praise God. And I thank you so much for calling in. So, here we go. Let's go with Brother Boyd here. Praise God. Remember Brother Boyd out there in Idaho, you know, he's got his plate full with taking care of a handicapped a sister, and he's got an elderly mother, and you know, he's always on fire for Jesus. That's one thing we all got to understand, that he's always, he never took his coat off for God. See, he's always putting himself first. He's always got to be a servant. See, we can't be back and be a bunch of bitter people. See, right. Jesus says this, I am the truth, I am the way. See, my friend, I am. That's what we got to follow. Right. Not me, I am. I mean, right. That's being him, my friend. So, brothers and sisters, let's listen to this testimony. Praise God.
Hello, Brother Willie. I love you, and I'm praying for you. God bless you. This is Brother Boyd London in Idaho. We're doing the gathering get-together today, and I've been getting a chance to listen to Evangelist Chris Cheney preach. I praise and thank and glorify God. And like he's talking about, there's no half-heartedly following Jesus. You're either fully in or you're out. You're going to go to hell. And people who half-heartedly follow Jesus are going to end up burning in hell. That's what I keep trying to call in so much about. They're like, why do you keep bugging me about doing the will of God, about taking up my cross and following after Jesus, laying down my life for the gospel, getting sin out of my life, a little fornication, those sins don't really matter, a little homosexuality. It does matter. And if you hear anybody that's truly on fire for the Lord, like Evangelist Chris Cheney, we love him a lot, or Brother Bishop Eddie Cheney, or any of us that have been called to be watchmen, we're going to be warning you against sin and lukewarmness, because there's no half-heartedly following Jesus. Just like Evangelist Chris Cheney was saying, these all these preachers, these multi-million dollar preachers and all these people out there that are tickling the ears from the book of 2 Timothy, they've heaped around them a great number of teachers to say what their itching ears want to hear, and they've turned aside from the truth and turned away to myths. These people out there that are tickling the ear saying you can just believe in Jesus and live in a bunch of sin and you're covered by grace. You never have to go do anything for Jesus, the gospel. Just drive right by the homeless people. Drive right by the orphans and widows. Drive right by the kids on drugs. Just believe in Jesus. Sit in a church seat on Sunday. Go live in some sin. You're saved by grace. Go live how you want. You're saved by grace. They're all agents of the devil. And they got a whole lot of people deceived, living lukewarm, half-hearted Christian lives. I mean, look at it. We try to get people to share testimonies, thousands of them. They won't share a testimony. Try to get people to pray for people. They won't pray for people. They'll sit there and play video games all night. Try to talk to them about sin. Many of them are fornicating, living in homosexuality, cussing and cursing. Yet they say they believe in Jesus, and they're going to heaven. The preachers preach that it's okay. As long as you believe, no matter how you live, you're going to heaven. It's not true. You can't half-heartedly follow Jesus. Jesus said, many will say, Lord, Lord, but not have done the will of God, and be called workers of iniquity and cast out. If anyone comes after me, they must deny themselves, take up their cross daily, and give up and lose their life for me and the gospel. That's the standard Jesus sets. And I can tell you, if you're half-heartedly following Jesus and you've got sin in your life, you will not go where Jesus is. You can read it at the ending of Revelation. If you're not laying down your life, helping out ministries, praying for others, sharing testimonies, laying down your life for Jesus and the gospel and keeping your life for yourself, and you're not doing his will, he's going to look right at you and say, depart from me, you worker of iniquity, I never knew you. This is serious, because we have a whole lukewarm religious world of people living in sin that won't feed people, that won't clothe people, that won't pray for others, that won't do anything for the Lord. They think they're saved, and they're going to split hell wide open. It's the truth. You better truly turn your heart and life over to Jesus. Let the Lord help you repent and become a doer of the word. You better become a doer of the word. Amen.
Half-hearted faith. I don't know about you, Pastor Steve, but I wouldn't want that half-hearted faith. No, it's all the way or nothing. Amen. You know, praise God. That's what God's coming back for. He ain't going to take percentage of your heart. He's coming for your whole soul, amen, my friend. See, that's why so many times I come across this mic, and I'll tell you this, that God don't take partial custody.
Amen.
It's all or nothing. Amen. See, my friend, you want to be inside that door of heaven, you got to have to step up to the plate, my friend. God didn't say it was going to be a bed of roses, but he'd tell you he'd be there with you all the way, didn't he? Mm. Praise God. You know, there's a lot of times that I walk alone, praise God, that I have to go preach the gospel over in this county or in that county. But you know, my pastor, praise God, I'm going to do a little bragging on him. I know I'm going to make his head swell a little bit. But you know, he sat over here in his chair with me the other day. He says, well, Brother Willie, the Lord has told me that every time that I have a service, that I'm hoped to be here to back you up. And I said, well, you obey God.
Man.
That's what we all want to do today. So, my friends, Pastor Steve Bailey is going to start being with me more.
I was a slave to my sinful way. The natural man, it seemed, was here to stay. I was losing my soul with nothing to gain, until I met the man who broke my chain. I was shackled in fear, surrounded by doubt. The devil told me there was no way out. I was headed for hell like a runaway train, till that day when Jesus broke my chain. Oh yes, it broke my chain, and it set me free. I was bought with a price, he paid at Calvary. Man, he saved my soul, and he wrote my name. I remember the day when Jesus broke my chain. I was drowning in sin, all my hope was gone, and all I could sing was old prison song. But it changed my tune, I'll never be the same. I walk a different way now that it broke my chain. Oh, yes, it broke my chain, and it set me free. I was bought with a price, he paid at Calvary. He saved my soul, and he wrote my name. I remember the day when Jesus broke my chain. Now he's been breaking chains for thousands of years, binding up wounds and drying tears. He shed his blood to cover your shame. Now lift your hand and let him break your chain. Oh, oh, yes, it broke my chain, and it set me free.
As a long lost way you go, all the clouds may hide the light of day, but don't you lose faith, for friend, you know that God's love will roll all the clouds.
I am, my Amen. Friend. Because he is worthy to be worshipped. He is worthy to give your heart, your mind, your body, soul, and spirit. Because if you don't give all of that, he can't take it. See, that's what the problem with a lot of people don't understand today, Pastor Steve.
Amen.
Is that if you don't give it, he can't take it.
That's right.
You know, that's something the Lord was just showing me right there. We all, often we gather together and we raise our hands and we scream and holler and all this stuff. But you know, the simplest form to be with God, you must be in the Spirit. You know, it's like this. You remember the old ringtone phone?
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Okay. Now imagine this, that if we were that ringtone phone, all right? And God was smoke signal. You think a ringtone phone would contact a smoke signal?
Nope.
See, that's why we got to be a mirror image of Him. Praise God. See, because what He does, that's what we're supposed to do. Praise God. If He tells us to go walk in the Spirit, go walk in the Spirit. Let me tell you something. Once you get in that Spirit, you don't want to come back. Oh, no. You want to be right up there with Him. But, my friend, we got the flesh we got to deal with, too. See, this body is dying daily, praise God, but I'm glad it's dying daily, because I know that every pain that I hurt, every suffer that I have, and all broken hearts I have, I know one day that's all going to be gone.
Amen.
Praise God, there won't be no death up there, there won't be no tombstone, there won't be no jailhouse, there won't be no lawyers, there won't be none of this junk upon this earth, because you know why? Because it's free for the ones that will grab a hold of Jesus Christ today. Amen. Praise God. So let's grab another testimony over here. Praise God. Well, if I get the right button here. Pastor Steve, I think I got the same kind of finger you got going on. You know, the stiff finger deal?
Mm-hmm.
Praise God. Praise God. Let's remember Brother Eddie Chaney of the Gospel Music Jukebox. Amen. Praise God. I was looking across Facebook earlier, and he said he wouldn't be on tonight, but I figure Brother Steve, I got you on my mind, brother. You got something to speak about today. Brother King, praise God, he'll probably cover tonight. So everybody keep him in prayer and let God be God in all fashions and forms. Praise God. Let's remember Sister Shirley down there. She's been having blood pressure problems. Praise God. Let God take care of that. You know, let's pray that she come healthy and have blood pressure stay on that level. Because I know I had blood pressure issues, and I know that you have blood pressure issues.
Amen.
You know, I'll tell you what blood pressure is to me. It's like an old kettle about half full of water. All right? Mm-hmm. And then when you put it too hot, what happens? It boils over. So, my friend, keep your kettle about halfway tuned. Keep it right with God. And let me tell you something. The best medicine you can ever put in your mouth is the Word of God.
Amen.
See, my friend, he is the healing power of His glory. Praise God. And you know what we need to do today is grab a hold of that to tell the world that God is not dead, my friend. He is very much alive, and He is in the miracle-working business. Praise God. So, my friends, today, what are you doing for Jesus today? This beautiful Sunday. Well, day's Wednesday. Oh, I get my days mixed up there, brother.
Oh, well.
Praise God. It's Sunday everywhere. Amen. If you got God, it's a Sunday day for everybody. Amen. Praise God. You know, a lot of people get caught up in a lot of foolish things. Praise God.
Oh,
but I tell you,
Lord, it's Sunday morning down in your soul.
Amen. Sunday morning down in your soul. So, brother and sister, we got one here from Scottsville. Praise God. Pastor Kenny. So, brother and sister, let's enjoy this testimony.
Hello, this is Kenneth Bachman, Pastor Kenneth Bachman from Storehouse Ministries. Love you guys, but I love Jesus more. Hey, man, I love Jesus more. Hey, I just wanted to give a shout out to you guys and tell you how much I appreciate you and what you're doing. Keep on keeping on. Be strong in the Lord, amen. Be strong in Jesus. I'll give you a call back after a little while. Love you guys. Bye-bye.
Well, praise the Lord.
Amen.
Brother Kenny from Storehouse Ministry down here in Scottsville. He just, the Lord called, I guess called to him to pastor. Praise God. let's keep him in prayer that more souls for the kingdom of God be saved.
Amen.
God, you know one thing that we all got to do, we got to get in that spirit. Praise God, the spirit of God. You know, there's a lot of times that we come to church and we're hoping somebody might sing a song that change our heart or some testimony that might bring us up. My friend, you don't have to wait for somebody to do something.
Exactly.
See, God says you stand up. He tells you to get up and walk. He tells you to preach his gospel. So my friend, if you're down in that battle today and you don't know what you're going to do, hey, I'll tell you what you need to do. You need to grab a hold of a little more of God. Amen. See, God to me is more than just a good man. He is my Lord. He's my Savior. He's my salvation, my friend. So my friends, enjoy this song. More than a good man.
Questions are rising about the deity of Christ, but if you were to ask me, I wouldn't even think twice, 'cause I talked to him this morning.
Emergency prayer come through the chat room. Brother Boyd saying, this is Boyd. My sister Ann London is very sick. We have to get her to the hospital right now. She is very weak and can't walk and has been shaking. And thanks you for the prayer. So, Brother Pastor Steve, would you come up to this golden mic and say one of them powerful prayers upon her through the Lord Jesus Christ?
Brother Boyd, I'll tell you what, through his stripes we're healed. And I'll tell you something else. Just believe when you call on his name. Our kind, loving Heavenly Father, it's again we come to you, Lord, just to look through the airwaves, Lord. Father, we know that Isaiah 53 and 5 says, through your stripes we're healed. And Heavenly Father, we ask, Lord, that you'll just, through your precious blood, just touch Brother Lord's wife, Lord, that she would be healed of whatever it may be that she has. Heavenly Father, be with those all that are sick, Lord. Whether it be a loss, sickness in health, or sickness in spirit, Lord, just touch that sickness, whatever it might be. Now, Father, we ask these things in the name of Jesus Christ, our only Son. Amen and amen.
Amen, amen. Thank you, Pastor. Amen. And we come to agreement with you, Pastor Steve, that this healing is coming across the airways right now. We pray that it touches her heart, her body, and her soul.
Amen.
That if the sickness be gone before she can get to the hospital,
amen,
all that shaking and all that aching and pains, that be gone. She'd be healed by the blood of Jesus Christ, by the stripes, by the Holy Ghost of the Holy Most. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God. Today we need to pray for one another when the time and hour is in.
Amen.
Don't wait till Sunday. Don't wait till next week.
Amen.
Wait right now and pray for them, because today is the day of salvation. It's time to quit playing on the pity-patty game and start serving the mighty God. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God. Enjoy this song.
me to believe in something that I couldn't see. I'm begging you to put faith in a guy like me. But there's times if I had a gun, only you and me know what I might have done. But now to you I come.
Praise God, praise God. Please remember me. Amen. You know, God is good, ain't he, Pastor Steve?
Amen.
You know, every day we wake up, we should continue and sacrifice and praise for him. Because, you know, if we don't praise him, how's he ever going to bless our lives? Amen. How are you ever going to bless others if we never speak his name? See, my friend, the power in the name of Jesus Christ could chase every demon out of your life today. He could bring you deliverance today. Amen. If you're in the drug or alcohol state of mind, my friend, grab a hold of the great water, that fountain of water that God has put in your life that you'll never thirst again. See, my friends, today, that's the problem of the world today. Everybody thinks you got to go to some fancy church or you got to have some kind of fancy preaching. Let me tell you, it says, all it says in the Word of God is to have faith,
amen,
hope, and trust,
amen,
and what? Believe! That's what it says, my friend. You must believe that Jesus Christ died on a rugged cross for you. You must believe that he arose on that third day. And you must believe that he has the power of over all things. See, my friend, there ain't nothing goes on in this world without God.
Amen.
See, even the people when they pass away, unless God allows it, they don't pass till it's time. See,
amen,
my friend, our Lord has a protocol we go by that we must show love, we show mercy. But sometimes we got to go show correction, reproving. See, my friend, that's the problem with the world today. They think, well, every preacher's up just to cut everybody else down. My friend, I'm not here to cut you down. I'm here to lift you up closer to God. I'm telling you today that if you're not working with God, you're working against him. And you work against him, I tell you, you're going to lose that battle, my friend. You're going to lose that battle very quickly. See, my friend, no one can take down the hands of God, because God give his hands, stretched them out to them nails upon his hands, my friend. And he says, anyone that believe in me, that what? Shall be saved.
Amen.
He didn't say maybe. It hopefully, he says, shall be saved. Praise God. So my friends and family today, I hope today that you come in to hear a little fired up about word about God, and most of all, how to please God. And you can't just sit there and say, well, I've been doing this for 40-something years the way it is, and this worked for me. My friend, sometimes you got to stir that pot.
Amen.
Sometimes you got to step outside that box. Sometimes you just got to get away from the devil,
amen,
get built up with God, and then go back into the camp and whip his tail, because that's what he needs. He needs a good old-fashioned kicking. Amen? Praise
amen.
God. So, brothers and sisters, enjoy this song here.
Jesus Christ was a man that traveled through the land, a carpenter true and brave. And he said to the rich, give your goods to the poor. And they laid Jesus Christ in the grave. He went to the sick, and he went to the poor, and he went to the hungry and the lame. And he said that the meek would inherit the whole world. And they laid Jesus Christ in the grave. One day Jesus stopped at a rich man's door. What must I do to be saved? Take all you own and give it to the poor. And they laid Jesus Christ in the grave. when the love of the poor shall one day turn to hate, when the patience of the workers give way. Would be better for the rich if they'd never been born, so they laid Jesus Christ in the grave. When Jesus came to town, all the working folks around believed what he did say. But bankers and preachers nailed him to the cross, and they laid Jesus Christ in the grave. Well, the people held their breath when they heard about his death, and everybody wondered why. Was the landlord and soldiers, lawmen there had hired, that nailed Jesus Christ in the sky? We would lay Jesus Christ in the grave, Lord, Lord. We would lay Jesus Christ in the grave. If Jesus preached today like he preached in Galilee, we would lay Jesus Christ in his grave.
Amen. Praise God. What do you think about that, Pastor?
If we preach like what Jesus did back in Galilee, well, they would run us out of town, wouldn't they? They wouldn't want the true power of God coming to life. All they have come to cover their sin. My friend, let me tell you something. I'm here to tell you, if you're living in darkness and you think you want to buy your way into heaven, you're ready serving God in a glory way. My friend, the only way is the price has already been paid. Upon a cross with his blood. See, my friend, I don't give a care if you got $50 or $50,000 in your bank account. All that's going to burn like paper one day, my friend. What he wants is something that you can't buy.
Amen.
He wants your soul. He wants your spirit. He wants to come and take back what he created in you. See, my friend, today you've got to understand, where do you stand with God? Are you standing in the midst? Or you stand all around him? See, my friend, I see so many people that go to church and they'll sit in the very back pew and they'll sit there and just watch and admire everybody. Well, they ain't right with God. I seen them doing this the other day. Well, I heard something about this old boy. See, they'll pick apart people's religion or faith. Praise God. But when somebody comes stepping on their toes, judge me not, my friend. There's going to be a great judgment one day, the great judge, and that's our Jesus Christ. See, my friend, there's going to be a courtroom, praise God, up in heaven on that great judgment Roman day. Praise God, and that's where people are going to be thinking, well, he was a good man down here. But let me tell you something, if you got guilt in your heart, my friend, that'll be brought out in front of the court and among the eyes of God. See, whatever you speak about in the secret will be spoken or sung from the rooftop. Whatever's done in the darkness will be brought to the light. See, my friend, you can't hide it forever. You think you got it made, but my friend, if you try to cheat somebody out of something in some evil way, my friend, and you calling it good, I'll show you what's going to be good one day, because God's going to come look at you and say, I never knew you. Why'd you do that? I gave you my only begotten son. He gave his blood for you. And all you want to do is get a bank account? My friend, what is wrong with the world today when they don't serve God no more? All they want is have a fluffy house. My friend, they want to put sugar in their ear. They want to be petted on for their sin. My friend, I'm going to tell you, I ain't going to pitch you. Sin, I'm going to kick you in the rear and say, get right or get burnt. That's the way it is, my friend. See, today is the day of salvation. You can stand up, kick and scream, cuss me out all you want. I don't care. Amen. But I serve a mighty King that died on a rugged cross for me, that I could be free, free indeed. And that's the way I'm going to live my life. Free! Praise God. Amen. So my brothers and sisters, I don't know about you, but I'm fixing to kick the old devil right in the tail. Amen. Praise God. So brothers and sisters, let's listen to this song here. Good, good Father.
Oh, I've heard a thousand stories. is what they think you're like, but I've heard the tender whisper of love in the dead of night, and you tell me that you're pleased and that I'm never alone. You're a good, good father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm in love by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. Oh, and I've seen many searching for answers far and wide, but I know we're all searching for answers. Only you provide, 'cause you know just what we need before we say a word. You're a good, good father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm in love by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. Hardly speak, peace so unexplainable. I can hardly think as you call me, deeper still as you call.
Running down your face to wipe you and help you up and pick you up. He's there when you are being mischievous or in sin. He comes to correct you, my friend. He's there when you are down and out. No one else wants to hear your prayers or hear your trouble. Our Father has a big ear. See, thank my friend, we have an ultimate Father.
Yes, we do.
Praise God. Now, I had a dad upon this earth, but you know one thing my dad always told me when I was growing up? He said, don't you ever, ever call me Father. You call me Daddy, Pappy, Old Man, whatever, but don't you ever call me Father. Because there, and that's what I learned in that moment when he said this. He said, there's only one Father, and that's the Father of Heaven. And I've read, looked up that scripture, and it's true. See that? Now there's this little guy they call the Pope, amen, that needs to be saved. Praise God. But anyways, he calls himself a father. My friend, he ain't no father.
Amen.
He's an element of the devil. That's what
amen.
He is. See, my friend, Bible calls says do not call no man father except Father of Heaven. So my friend, my family, I think my pastor over here has got his twinkle toes on and ready to bring the word. So brothers and sisters, let's go to prayer right now. Lord, Heavenly Father, we come before you, mighty God. We ask you, Lord, to lighten him up, give him strength, knowledge, your wisdom, Lord. We ask you, mighty God, that your power be upon him and his life today, Lord. Lord, let him touch the law from the undone out there today, Lord. Let him touch the one that has you, Lord, that steps away, Lord. We ask you, mighty God, that you lift him up and put the words in his mouth to speak, Lord, and give him all your glory and your power, Lord. And Lord, let this room be filled with the Holy Ghost. Lord, we ask you, mighty God, let the words go out today be healing and conviction upon their hearts and spirit today, Lord. We ask you, mighty Jesus, that you touch them, make them, sink them, and send them on their way, Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen and amen. The congregation says, amen. So, brothers and sisters, get ready. Here comes the wild man, Pastor Steve Bailey. Praise God.
Bless your heart, my brother.
Amen.
Brother Willie, the name of the sermon ought to be now.
Where have you got your house built?
That's right, come on. People accept the Lord, build the house.
He'll not likely stand.
That's right.
But accept the Lord, build the house. No labor in vain. If you build a house, you ought to have a foundation for it, Brother Willie. It's got to be a sound foundation.
That's right.
If you don't build it on the rock, then it's going to sink.
That's right. Come on.
People, I'll tell you what, there are a lot of preachers out there in this life today. A lot of churches need to build their house upon the rock.
That's right.
Instead of on the sinking sand. People, I'll tell you what, this thing about I think so is over with.
That's
you
right.
Better know so.
Preach it.
Because if you don't know, then how's the Lord going to know you?
That's right. Come on now.
People, I'll tell you what, it is vain for you to rise up early and to sit up late. Eat the bread of sorrows. So he giveth his beloved sleep. People, if you don't have a Lord in your life, you're going to reap sorrow in your life.
That's right. Come on.
People, if you don't have the Lord in your life, you're going to be like a lost sheep. People, I'll tell you what, there's shepherds out there every day looking for that lost sheep in
their
life.
That's right. Amen.
But that sheep's got to come back to the shepherd on his own.
That's right.
People, I'll tell you what, we've got a Lord that's taking care of business today. Lord, children, we're in a heritage of the Lord. And the fruit of the womb is his reward.
That's right.
As arrows are in the hand of a mighty man, so are the children of the earth, the youth. Happy is the man that has his quiver full of them. They shall not be ashamed, but they shall speak with the enemy's gate. People, the children he's talking about here are the children of God.
That's right, come on.
And I'll tell you what, Brother Willie, the true child of God will follow God where we go.
Praise God, come on.
He will not turn his back on God. That's the trouble of churches nowadays. They've turned their backs on God. They're preaching false prophecy. People, I tell you, it's time for a true prophet of God to take the pulpit over and give them a dose of good old homegrown salvation.
That's right, come on.
People, I tell you what, The Lord is good to us, but sometimes we fail seeing it. We're going over to Luke this afternoon, the 6th chapter and the 48th verse. He is like a man which built an house and dig deep and laid foundation on the rock. When the flood arose and the spirit and the stream beat vehemently upon that house, and could not shake it, for it was founded all upon a rock. Is your life founded on the rock this afternoon? There's your life on that unshakable rock called Jesus Christ.
That's right.
If not, people, it's like the second man that built the house upon the sand. He built his house on the sand, Brother Willie, but through the life storms, life floods, they took the house over and it was destroyed because he didn't have his life built on the firm foundation.
Praise God, come on.
People, I tell you what, our foundation built a house upon the earth against which the stream did beat vehemently, and immediately it fell, and the ruin of that house was great.
Mm-hmm.
People, I tell you what, if you haven't got your life built on the rock, Jesus Christ, and it's going to go down in life.
That's right.
It's going to blow away in life like sand, Brother Willie.
That's right, come on.
Life is like sand. It could blow away at any minute. But I'm going to tell you what, if you've got your life built on that rock, Jesus Christ, the winds of life can't shake it.
That's right.
And the floods of life can't wash it away.
Praise God, come on.
People, I'll tell you what, it's one of them things there, people, that the termites can't mark foundation. And the floods can't wash it away. People, I'll tell you what, if your life is centered on Jesus Christ this afternoon, it's centered on the solid rock, which, people, I'll tell you what, the floods of life can't wash away.
Woo, come on.
People, I'll tell you what, there's a lot of churches out there this day and time.
Mm-hmm.
They need a dose of the rock that never fails.
That's right, come on.
People, I'll tell you what, that church will kneel or get to his knees and seek out the Lord for salvation. Then it will build its house upon the rock.
That's right.
People, I'll tell you what, we've got a Lord that can take care of our lives if we'll only give him a chance.
That's right, praise God.
People, one day the mercy gate's going to be closed. And what's your life going to be?
That's right.
Is it going to be founded on the rock? Or is it going to be founded upon the shaky sand of life?
That's right.
People, we'll be praying for you. And may the Lord bless you and keep you this afternoon.
Well, glory. Praise God. What a word. What are you built on, rock or sand today, my friend? Praise God. Are you built by Jesus or are you built by your own? See, my friend, who's your contract in your spirit today? Is it the devil and he's just putting a bunch of trash around you, my friend? Or are you built by the great I am? Are you an overcomer by the word and testimony of Jesus Christ? Praise God. You know, today is the day of salvation, my friend. You ain't got time to be dabbling about stupid things. You got time to be doing this. You can be an overcomer this very moment, this very hour. So, my friend, enjoy this song here. Overcomer.
I'm not nothing really.
Well, glory, hallelujah. Are you an overcomer today? Praise God, I hope you are. Amen, praise God. You know, before we get off here, I got one little word to say to you, my friends. Over here in Revelation 4, praise God, and starting at the 10th verse, it says this, 420 elders fell down before him that sat on the throne and worshiped him that lived forever and ever.
Amen.
And cast down their crown before the throne.
Amen.
Saying, Thou art worthy, O Lord,
Amen.
To receive glory and honor and power to the Amen. Creations of all things and
Bless
for you, the pleasant that are with creation.
Amen.
See, my friend, you're created this very moment. You come into this world of sin. But my friend, there's a gown and a crown waiting for you. And one day, once we let go and put our cross down before that gate,
Amen.
And we walk into that glorious land, my friend, we'll be around the throne room of God for eternity.
Amen.
See, my friend, I ain't gonna tell you that life is easy, because it ain't. I've been on this earth almost 40 years, my friend, and I have had more swinging at me than I had
Amen.
Smiles. But you know what I do? I love them. I pray for them.
Amen.
See, the Lord tells us to do that. He says, pray for the ones that despitefully use you.
Amen.
See, my friend, I've been used, abused, and called tattooed. Amen. But you know, one thing, I know Jesus Christ will not abuse me. I want
right.
him to use me for his kingdom.
Right.
That I could touch somebody's heart,
Amen.
Touch somebody's life, put a change in somebody out there today that needs just
Amen.
A little touch from God. I'm not going to choke you with the word of God. I'm not going to say, you don't do it this way, you're going to hell. My friend, if you're guilty, you're guilty.
Amen.
You don't tell an alcoholic he's a drunk, do you? Why? No, because he knows that.
Amen.
But we can tell him how to get away from being an alcoholic,
Amen.
And that's through the blood of Jesus Christ. Amen. You don't go tell a whore that she's a whore, because she knows that.
Amen.
But you can tell her how to come be an overcomer and come away from being a whore no more.
Amen.
To be pure as a child, my friend.
Amen.
Praise God, you know a lot of people. Thanks. It takes a lot of bells and whistles and pretty shiny things to serve God. All you got to do is be faithful, true, and believe. So my friends, my family, as we sign off today, remember us in prayer as we remember you. Like I said, let's remember Sister Ann, Brother Boyd's sister. They're on taking her to the hospital. I believe in my heart that she's healed. That God has already touched her. She's sealed and sanctified. And she's screaming, giving praises to God right now. So I believe that she's healed. And if the Lord says it's time for her to go, praise God. The girl's faithful. I can tell that. So I think she's ready to go. So if you can't get on this side, get on the other side. Amen. Praise God. So, brothers and sisters, as we sign off today, remember us all in prayer. Most of all, remember Brother Eddie Cheney, I've seen up here on Facebook that he was pretty sick, praise God. That, he's feeling bad. I don't know about sick, but he's feeling bad. And he won't be on tonight, but Brother Kenny said he's going to try to be on tonight. So let's tune in. I don't know what time he'll be on, but praise God. Whenever it is, it'll be exciting. Amen. Praise God. So, brothers and sisters, let's remember Brother Greg Dotson, Consumed by Fire Ministries, praise God, he'll be on at 5, praise God. That won't you tune over there and support the brother in all in prayer in any way that you see fit. Hey, remember do the Gospel Music Jukebox too. Remember they got that testimony number too. 1-931-229-0768. Hey, call them up. Tell them what encouragement they've given you today. Amen. So, brothers and sisters, as me and my pastor says all the time, I'll meet you here, there, or in the air.
Amen.
But wherever we be, we'll see you again.
Amen.
Praise God. Love you guys. Remember some prayer. And remember that Jesus loved you before anybody loved you. Amen. Love you guys.
God bless. One day in an old country church house, I heard Mother pray for me then. She prayed for the Savior to guide me to the beautiful altar of prayer. She walked down the aisle there toward me. The tears then came to her eyes, and she said, "Son, I've been praying for you, for fear that in sin you might
Everybody, right now, Pastor Steve just remembered something about his sister needing prayer. So, brothers and sisters, right now, we're going to get up right now, and we're going to say a prayer over. Amen. So, what's her name, brother?
Pam.
Pam?
Yes.
All right. Lord of Heavenly Father, we come before you, mighty God. We ask you, mighty God, that you touch her heart, her soul, and her body right now, Lord. We ask you, mighty God, that your holy power come upon her wherever she is, mighty God. Let the power of the Ghost, the Holy Ghost, come upon her, Lord. Lord, let the devil know where he stands right now, under her feet and on the bottom of the hill, in the pits of hell. Lord, we ask you, Lord, to send the anointing down of your blood and your mercy, Lord. Lord, let her be raising up to you today, Lord. We ask you, mighty God, that your holy power be on her. Lord, woo, come on, God. She has, Lord, send it upon her, Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray.
Amen.
And we claim that healing right now. She be healed by the grace and the mercy and the Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you all. Please continue to pray.
Amen. She prayed for the Savior to guide me to the beautiful altar of prayer. My soul has been saved by
friends, what a wonderful time we've had a fellowship today on the House of Prayer Ministry radio program. And I tell you, we're so appreciative of you coming by, so thankful that you came by and stopped in with us today. And we just pray that something another that we have said or played has been a blessing to you today. And hey, if it has been, please hit us up on our call-in testimony line at 270-681-8098. That's 270-681-8098. And feel free to leave a prayer request on there, leave your pre-recorded testimony, or hey, if you got a song request, something other you'd like us to play on the next broadcast, just feel free to leave that song request in there too. Hey, if you'd like to drop us a card in the mail, go ahead. You can reach us at 207 South Welch Street over in Scottsville, Kentucky, 42164. Once again, friends, that's 207 South Welch Street in Scottsville, Kentucky, 42164. If you'd like to drop us an email, feel free to go ahead and do that. You can reach us at brothergrizzle76@gmail.com. Once again, that's brothergrizzle76@gmail.com. And hey, we sure do appreciate you dropping by once again and tuning in to the broadcast. And we just look forward to the next time that we get to come on the air and share the love of God with you in testimony, word, and song. May God bless you richly this day is our prayer here from the House of Prayer Radio Ministry.
Trust a promise he'll keep us by his side, and the child of God can survive. Child of God can survive. I had a good friend in New York City. He never called me by my name, just Hillbilly. His granddaddy taught him, trust the work of your hands. While I believed Jesus was more than a man, he used to laugh and talk about his honky-tonk nights. While I spoke of Jesus who could change his life. He was saved one day from a lake of fire. He joined the church, now he sings in the choir. He now jumps and shouts, thanking God he's alive, 'cause a child of God can survive. A child of God can survive. Cause you can't hold us back and you can't make us run, 'cause we're the child of God washed in his blood. Yeah. We say grace and we say man. If you ain't into that, you ain't saved by the man. We're from North California and South Alabama and little towns all around this land. We will trust a promise he'll keep us by his side, and a child of God can survive. Child of God can survive. Child of God can survive. That's right.